All right, let's get started. Are you having a fun Ignite so far? I'm sorry, I can't hear you. Are you having a fun Ignite so far? Okay, that's much better. My name is Premal Shah. I'm a product manager in the Azure Databricks team. It's really nice to have you here. Again, my apologies, my voice is a little hoarse, but I will try to push along and try to talk as loudly as I can. Today's session is about machine learning, and it's about Azure Databricks and Azure machine learning, and them sort of working better together. I'll try to shout on top of this. How many have heard of Azure Databricks, or at least, you know, oh, perfect. How about Azure machine learning? Perfect, perfect. So let me just move ahead. So let's, before we go jump into sort of what is the integration means, let's look at the challenges that, you know, ML development faces. So machine learning development is hard. You know, it's harder than solving sort of software related problems. And some of the challenges are that to build a machine learning model, you have to prep data from a variety of data sources using a variety of tools. To top it all off, you know, in traditional software development, you're trying to conform to a certain amount of, you know, specification. So for example, when I click this particular button, you know, this kind of behavior happens. In machine learning, you're trying to get to the most accurate model. So your goal is to optimize on a specific metric. On top of that, you know, you have, you know, data quality issues. So you have to make sure that your data is high quality. And a model has different numbers of hyperparameters that you have to use. So again, the challenge sort of compounds on top of that. You know, we all data scientists, we know that to come up with a good model, you have to use like a variety of tools, variety of frameworks. So you have, you know, different kinds of frameworks that you have to use. Again, the complexity of the model increases. And all of these you have to keep track, right? So as you're building models, you know, keeping all this in mind, you have to keep track of how did I arrive at the right model, what kind of model am I using, how, you know, you have to maintain history of all the model building that you did so you can pick the perfect model. So there's a lot of experimentation involved in all of that. Once you're done with sort of building a model, then comes the even more difficult part of how do you sort of productionalize a model? So how do you push a model to production in the right manner, using the appropriate, you know, DevOps pipelines to push this model into production so that it doesn't, you know, fare worse than what you already have in production. And finally, once you have the model in production, you have to figure out how to monitor the model, right? So what if you push the model to production and then there's some data drift and you have to, you know, retrain the model? So there's like a cycle of things that sort of continue as you are sort of retraining and building the model again. And of course, as enterprises, you want basically governance, you want scale, and of course you want your solution to be secure. So before we go into sort of the integration, I just wanted to talk about Azure Databricks really quickly. Most of you have, you know, are familiar with it, but basically it's a fast, easy, collaborative Spark solution in the cloud. We have partnered with Databricks, which is, you know, the world's leading company for Spark development. It's a first-party Azure service, and our philosophy is that we want to make things very easy for customers. So we want customers to not worry about sort of the traditional operations element that comes with big data systems, and we want you to focus on your business logic. The second is that we, of course, want the solution to be secure, so we want it to be built on Azure, which is the security that you guys have come to expect from us, so that's a big focus for us. And finally, any big data system has to scale, right? So it has to have the appropriate technically infinite ability to grow to any size that you want. And the beauty of Azure Databricks is that it actually scales along with you. So you can start small, you can go big, you can come back to, you know, where you were. So the auto-scaling feature of the product allows you to scale up and scale down as your workloads, you know, come and go. And of course, we have a lot of sort of Azure integrations that we have done to make it truly like a first-party experience. Azure Machine Learning is our end-to-end cloud and AI offering in Azure. And basically, again, the whole idea behind Azure Machine Learning is the first thing we want to do is we want to help you increase your productivity as a data scientist so that you as a data scientist, we really want to meet you where you are. So you don't have to leave the comfort of, you know, you're working in whichever IDE you want. With Python SDK that some of you might have actually seen, you can really build models from anywhere you basically like. Also with the automated ML features in Azure Machine Learning, you can sort of build models much quicker, so time to market for pushing models to production is much, much better. As I mentioned in the previous couple of slides, is that the rate of experimentation is very important because you're playing around with different models before you get to the perfect model, so there is a lot of experimentation involved, and Azure Machine Learning helps you that rapid set of experimentation. And finally, one of the key strengths of Azure Machine Learning is its model deployment capabilities and model management. So once you deploy a model, how do you manage the model? How do you monitor the model? How do you retrain the model? So the whole model management lifecycle is very critical to Azure Machine Learning and what it offers. So this is a typical end-to-end machine learning lifecycle. You prepare data, build model, you sort of test it, you validate it, you deploy it, you monitor it. All of you are familiar with this. There are different interpretations of this, but this is just sort of one such interpretation. And then the important thing here is that this is not really a linear process, right? So this is a cyclical process, and you want to have this ML lifecycle. Sort of as you're building a model, retraining it, testing it, deploying it, and so on. So how have we in Azure Databricks and Azure Machine Learning tried to solve this problem? So if you're an Azure Databricks customer, MLflow, how many have heard of MLflow here? Yeah, so few. So MLflow is an open source product. It's an ML lifecycle management tool that got released last year in July. And since then, it has had rapid adoption. What Spark could not get to in 3 years, MLflow, people are using it in like 1 year. So it has a lot of rapid adoption. So what we've done is we've taken MLflow and AML, and we have combined them for you to be able to log your experiments in a single place. You can maintain audit trails. You can deploy a model seamlessly. You can manage your model seamlessly. And I have a demo to show you, so I'm going to just breeze through the slide so we can actually get to the demo. Okay, so there are three components to MLflow. One is, and just to let you know, it has 140 contributors. They're growing fast. There are 800K downloads per month. I encourage you to go check out MLflow. It's pretty cool. And it has three components to it. It has tracking. So for example, I mentioned about experimentation and the need for you to be able to log, models and also the parameters that you use to build the models. And then you have projects by which you can take an MLflow-based project, give it to somebody else, so they can run the project without really knowing about the underlying details of how you came up with that model. Today, the classic problem is if somebody gives me a model, I'll have to first install all the dependent libraries and so forth. So all of the pain is taken away from you. And finally, models is the common format that MLflow has, by which it can several tools, just like Azure Machine Learning, can use to then deploy the model to different surface areas, like you might want to deploy to the cloud or to the edge. And this is, again, sort of life cycle in Azure Databricks. You probably prep data using something like Delta Lake, and you track experiments and you deploy. So again, I'm just kind of rushing through the slides. I do want to get to the demo. But before I go on there, there is something more to the ML lifecycle, and this whole idea of MLOps. And how many have heard of MLOps here? Yeah. Excuse me. So there are a lot of talks here in Ignite on MLOps, and basically the idea is that unlike traditional operations where you build a model and deploy it, you go through a process. So Azure Machine Learning offers you a way for you to be able to train your model with different parameters, again capturing different runs. You can track, you can validate your model, so you can make sure that the model that you are building is better than the one that you have in production, both in terms of performance and accuracy and whichever metric you choose to. You can deploy your model seamlessly, and again, you can monitor your models, and then the whole retraining process goes on. All right, so let me just switch to the demo. Can you guys see the code on the notebook? Okay, cool. So let me show you the cool things we have done here to sort of combine the two experiences. So I'm in an Azure Databricks notebook here, and what I have done is I have linked my Azure Databricks workspace with an Azure Machine Learning workspace. So this is showing you the Azure Machine Learning workspace that has been linked to the Azure Databricks workspace. So we have introduced a new feature just a couple of months back, by which you can go to an Azure Databricks workspace, and using this link AML workspace button, you can actually link your AML workspace to the Azure machine learning workspace. So once you link these workspaces, then the experience of you doing MLflow and logging those results in AML becomes much simpler. So let me show you how. So if you go to the demo here, and if I show you my setup. So once I have linked those workspaces, then all I need to do is I need to have this init script where I'm actually setting this URL that you see. And this URL is not doing anything but actually telling MLflow that, hey, go and log all the runs and all the models in Azure Machine Learning Workspace. So the linking and the script allows you to be able to do that. Now this init script is run with every cluster. So as soon as a cluster starts up, it'll run this script so that you don't have to do it for every single notebook and every single cluster. So this kind of the setup, you've linked the workspaces, you've specified this init script where you specified this URL. So now you're sort of ready to go. So let me jump back to the application here. So here I have a very simple application. I have linked these two workspaces to begin with. And I have this sort of data coming from IoT devices, from an oil rig. And all I'm trying to do is that for a particular device and for these four sensors, I'm just trying to predict what is the fifth sensor. So what is the value sort of the fifth sensor? So it's a typical regression kind of a model that I'm trying to build. So once I have this data, as you see, this is a delta table that I have this data in. I'm displaying this data here. And now I'm going to use MLflow. So notice that there is no AML in the picture. I'm only using MLflow, but because I had linked these two workspaces and I've set those parameters, whenever I say MLflow, it's actually underneath the covers calling AML. So that's the beauty of the integration. So what I do is I set the experiment here. I say that this is what I want to experiment. An experiment has various runs in MLflow. So what I'm doing first is I'm building a Spark ML lib model. So this is again a random forest regressor. If you don't know what this is, don't worry about it. Basically, it's just predicting what is the value of that fifth sensor that I sort of talked about. And what I'm doing here is look at these calls here. So I'm sort of logging the model here. I'm logging the metric here. So I have these couple of metrics that I'm trying to log. I'm actually trying to log the model. So this is all MLflow, but underneath the hood, it's logging to AML. And I'll show you how. So if you go back to the AML workspace, if I go to experiments, if I click on this experiment here, this is an AML workspace. If I go here, if I go to, let's say, I think it's the fourth run. So while that is coming up, let me just jump, go on to the demo. So here I'm again building a scikit-learn model. And notice that when I'm building the scikit-learn model, I'm using three hyperparameters to build my model. So I have a model with depth as 2, depth as 10, depth as 20. So again, I'm sort of experimenting here. I'm logging different results of the model. I'm just using again a random forest regression. And once I do that, I should be able to see some runs here. So I clicked on this run. If I click on this output, this is the Python model that I logged. And if I go to details, this is showing me that this has the MSC of 0.011 and 0.9953. So this is just one run of the model. So there are many runs of the model that I'm logging. So let me jump back here and kind of walk you through. So once I have this model built and I've logged these runs in Azure Machine Learning, I can then go ahead and start my deployment process. So first I want to deploy my model as a batch scoring, because maybe I have this large set of data that I want to score in an Azure Databricks workspace. So I'm setting my workspaces here, my workspace config here, which I've linked. And then this call is actually loading the model from, so this is directly going to an Azure ML workspace. Excuse me. And actually getting the model, we just grab a drink of water here. Once I get the model, I then save the model to the local disk, and then I'm actually using it for batch scoring. So this is, I'm sort of leveraging the Azure Databricks Spark cluster to actually do my batch scoring of the model that I just built. What I could do is then I can use Azure ML to actually deploy the model as a web service. So this is where AML strengths come in, where I'm able to deploy the model using, again, I'm just using MLflow here. Notice that there is no Azure Machine Learning here. Underneath the covers is actually Azure Machine Learning. So I build the image, and then I do the deployment. So notice that this is the only call that I'm actually using an Azure Machine Learning call to deploy the image to the ACI service. You can deploy it to the cloud, you can deploy it to the edge. Azure Machine Learning has a variety of deployment options. So you can use any one which sort of meets your need. And then I'm doing my predictions. So I come in here and I can score my data, and I give some sample. I'm not running the notebooks because it'll just take a while to run it. So I'm just going to show you. I can share this notebook with you offline if there's interest. So I run this, and then I get back sort of the result. And this is actually, if I go back to AML here, what I'm actually calling is my deployed web service. So this is the service that I deployed. So it shows you the what service I deployed, and basically that's what I used to score the model. So let me just jump back. So I'll take questions in a couple of minutes. Let me jump back to the deck. But just wanted to show you kind of how we have sort of integrated the two, AML and MLflow. So what you saw in the demo is using tracking and model deployment using MLflow, but underneath the covers, it's actually using Azure Machine Learning. And all of this is being logged into an Azure Machine Learning workspace. So some of the things we have coming is we've already have what I just showed you is already available in public preview. So feel free to go use it. Feel free to give us feedback so we can sort of improve upon it. And for GA, which is expected Jan 2020, all this experience is going to become even more simpler. So once you link the Azure Machine Learning and AML workspace, you don't have to do anything else. You don't have to specify any kind of init script. It'll just like work completely out of the box. So that's an experience that you'll be working towards, and it should be available Jan 2020 for you guys to sort of check it out. I think that's all I had. I wanted to leave a couple of minutes for questions. Any questions from any of you? I really appreciate your patience and time. Thanks so much for being here.